what's up? This is Blaze, the movie fan, and it's time to go back to the past again. When it comes to going back to the past, you can't go much further than this. That's right, I am now taking a look at one of the very first Nostalgia Critic episodes, and it was made all the way back in 2008. Now I could watch the Tom and Jerry movie and make a movie review out of it, but I thought it would be more fun to watch it in order to respond to one of Nostalgia Critic's earlier reviews. Anyway, I fucking hate the show Tom and Jerry. I don't find the slapstick in that show funny or entertaining in the slightest. But my biggest problem with the show is the fact that Tom does nothing wrong. The only reason he's chasing Jerry is because he's fucking hungry. And the fact that I have the opposite opinion on the show than the Nostalgia Critic does is what I think would make for a very interesting discussion. So yeah, today I'm taking a look at Nostalgia Critic's review of the Tom and Jerry movie. So anyway, without further ado, let's begin.
I'm such a fucking dork that I actually went out and got the DVD collections of these cartoons.
Now this part of the video is something that holds up even better over a decade later. Nowadays, nobody really collects DVDs or Blu-rays anymore. You know what that makes them? That makes them very valuable collector's items. Because they are becoming more rare as time goes on. So yeah, those fucking DVDs are even more valuable now. It's interesting how some aspects of an old video can get better years later.
You know what I found out? I'm not the only one who regards them as comic legends. There's directors, historians, and even comedy stars like Whoopi Goldberg and Mad TV cast members who all see Tom and Jerry as comedic gold.
Well, I guess that means I'm the only one who fucking hates this show.
With a comedy team so legendary, you'd think Hollywood would put some real time and effort into their first feature-length film together. They do not.
What the hell did you expect? Of course they're not gonna put a lot of thought and effort into the movie. Most movies based on something popular butcher it to a massive degree. That does suck, but unfortunately, that's most often the case.
And look at this, when Tom gets cut in half in the cartoon, it's humorous. When Tom gets cut in the movie... Oh my god, that's blood! They actually show blood in this! What are they, fucking psychos?
I do see where you're coming from. This is a kid's movie after all. But the blood here isn't even that severe. Besides, it's only there for a few seconds. Now look, there's nothing wrong with pointing out minor issues with a movie. But the thing is, this isn't even part of the fucking movie. It's part of the opening credits. So you're pretty much complaining about a non-issue here.
So the two of them have to roam the streets looking for food and shelter. These are the only good parts of the movie where Tom and Jerry tried to decide whether they should help each other out or not. And all without any dialogue. There's even a cute in-joke with a restaurant called Bill and Joe's, obviously referencing Bill Hanna and Joseph Barbera, the show's creators.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, that is a wonderful scene.
But it all goes downhill when they meet this singing gay dog and his obnoxious little flea named Frankie.
I wouldn't exactly say that he is a homosexual. I mean, sure, he has a friend that he hangs around with a lot. But there is a big difference between a friendship and a sexual relationship. And that dog and the flea are just friends, nothing more. But that's not the problem that I have here. The problem I have is that you're calling him gay like it's a bad thing. Even if he was gay, so fucking what? There's nothing wrong with that. And calling him gay like it's a bad thing is very homophobic. And I hate homophobic remarks like this. There's absolutely nothing wrong with being a homosexual. And it's ignorant to think otherwise.
I'm Tom.
I'm Jerry.
What the hell? Did they just talk? Did Tom and Jerry, one of the most famous silent duos of all time, just speak to each other? No. It's gotta be a mistake. I gotta be hearing things. I'm gonna just go ahead and eat my customary 3-pound watermelon and drink my traditional pitcher of sangria both at the same time while I confirm how wrong I was about this ridiculous misunderstanding.
What do you think I am, a dummy?
You said it.
Holy crap! They talk! They actually talked! The apocalypse has finally begun, pigs are learning how to fly, Satan is skating his way to work, and I'm pretty sure that I just became a monkey's uncle. Unbelievable. I mean, just unbelievable. The one rule that you never break, and they broke it in the first 10 minutes. I mean, isn't that like one of the Ten Commandments or something? Thou shalt not lie, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife. Tom and Jerry don't talk.
So fucking what if they talk? Now I'm gonna have to be honest. The fact that they didn't talk in the original show is one of the main reasons why I find it so fucking boring. Now of course if you like the show because of that, that's cool, I respect your opinion. But I'm sorry to say, but the fact that Tom and Jerry talk in this movie is a pity reason to hate it. Now them being silent could work for a 7-minute short. I personally don't think that it does, but I understand why someone would think it does. But it wouldn't really work for a movie that's over an hour long. So really, I think the fact that they talk in this movie is actually a good thing.
But wait, it gets worse! Not only do they like to sing, they like to sing about how they don't like chasing each other and how they enjoy being friends.
The greatest gift in life's a friend. He's a daily dividend. Be like us and start a trend. We're friends to the end.
They became friends. So fucking what? The fact that they are able to settle their differences to become friends is a good thing. The fact that you have a problem with them being friends leads me to believe that you don't like the Tom and Jerry cartoons because you like their personalities. You like the show more because you like to see Tom and Jerry beating the shit out of each other. Now I know that you said in a video that you made years later that you do like their personalities. But I'm judging this review solely based on the arguments that you made in it. Furthermore, there is one very important thing that you're ignoring. And that's the fact that after the song was finished, Tom and Jerry said this.
A cat and a mouse? Friends? That's disgusting. No way.
That goes double for me.
This proves that they didn't really become friends after the song was finished. And at the top of that, throughout the movie, Tom and Jerry are struggling to become friends. I'm sure they help each other out a lot during the movie, that goes without saying. But they don't completely settle each other's differences and become friends. Now I'm not gonna assume that you left this out on purpose to make the movie look worse than it actually is. But you still should be very careful about not leaving out important plot elements in your review. Because leaving out important plot details like this makes your review misleading.
So Tom and Jerry set off on their own, while running into a strange gang of alley cats who like to do nothing more than to...
We got no time for taste!
Sing another song?! Oh come on, I already had one song cut the nuts off my childhood, I don't need another! Look at this, it's like West Side Pussy, I mean how can anyone find this entertaining? It's just torture!
Okay, there is one major problem that I have with this review that I have to point out. And that's the fact that you're complaining about the simple fact that this movie has songs. A lot of animated Disney movies are loaded with songs as well. If you have a problem with it here, but don't care if it's in those movies, then I'm calling you out for double standards. Besides, the songs in this movie aren't there just for the hell of it. They serve a purpose. And at the top of that, they all connect to the story.
Who the hell is this?
I'm Robin Starling. I'm afraid I don't have a home anymore.
I'm sorry, we're trying to shoot a movie here. Is there any chance you can just kind of mosey along and,
I'm an orphan. My mother died when I was a baby.
Sucks. You know, we have a lot of shooting to do, and it's actually about Tom and Jerry. I'm sure it's gonna be very funny once it comes out, but, you're kind of in the way right now, so if you could just, you know, kind of get out of the way, that'd be great.
Aunt Fig was always calling me orphan. She even stole my locket and threw it out the window. But I climbed out and found it.
You're really not gonna leave until we make a movie about you, huh?
If the movie was only about Tom and Jerry and no one else, it would get boring pretty fast. This character gives the movie a purpose. I mean, if you don't like her, that's fine, I respect your opinion. But he's still a very important aspect of the movie.
So yeah, you're probably thinking, what the hell does this have to do with Tom and Jerry? Well, I guess the writers felt that the story needed a little bit more conflict. Cause, you know, Tom and Jerry didn't have any conflict whatsoever.
I mean, that's perfectly reasonable to me. The movie really wouldn't work if it was just Tom and Jerry. So they introduced a new character to make the movie more interesting.
So you might be asking yourself, is there any slapstick in this movie? Well, there's a fat dog on a skateboard who seems to pester Tom and Jerry as they try to eat.
Special.
Oh yeah, and he sounds like Gollum. But again, why isn't it Tom and Jerry doing all the slapstick? I don't give a shit about the dog. I'm just praying they put him to sleep by the end of the movie.
Well, I wouldn't exactly call this slapstick. I mean, no one is really getting hurt or anything like that. But yeah, I agree that that dog isn't very interesting.
By the way, have you noticed the strange names in this movie? Dr. Applecheeks, Aunt Fig, Mr. Lickboot? These are sounding more like abstract fetishes.
There is a perfectly legitimate reason for those names. This is a comedy movie after all, so it makes sense that the names are stupid.
So while in the pet prison, guess who they bump into? No, not him. You! You killed Tom and Jerry! You turned them into friends and ruined the franchise!
What?
Silly nostalgia critic, don't you know that you can't kill a cartoon character by shooting them?
So, while Robin is stuck watching Captain Kitty's psychotic episode, she manages to tell him where she's going.
Tibet! Have you been to Tibet?
I don't know! Why don't you sing about it?
I've done it all!
Why does everybody have a song in this? Doesn't anybody just say yes or no anymore?
That's the fucking point. I mean, this is a musical after all. Oh, and to add to a previous point that I made, there are a lot of fucking characters introduced in the movie. And there is no way to introduce them properly without making the movie longer. So the next best thing is to give them songs. In just about a minute, you get to know everything that you need to fucking know about them. Without even needing to strengthen the length of the movie. And that's a good thing.
Was he gonna sexually assault it? I mean, what the hell?
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. That looks incredibly fucking awkward.
So let me clarify this for those of you who might have missed it. A cat and mouse are driving a ship trying to save the daughter of Indiana Jones while being chased by a purple people eater, a dog on a skateboard, a performing ship captain, his hand puppet Squawk, two Mexican wrestlers, and a doctor riding an ice cream cart. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Mindfuck.
The term mindfuck is usually used to describe something that makes no sense whatsoever. But this makes complete fucking sense if you think about it. I mean, all those people know that they will be rewarded $1 million if they get the girl. Hell, he even explained that in a clip that I skipped. So I don't see how this is a mindfuck moment.
It looks like all hope is gone for our three heroes until... It's Robin's father, Indiana Jones!
Now, I do see where you're coming from and thinking of this as Indiana Jones. Though I must point out that Indiana Jones' outfit isn't exclusive to him. Outfits like that is very common for adventurers in fiction, especially treasure hunters.
He rescues his daughter and leaves Tom and Jerry to burn alive in the fire. Wait, what? That's... dark?
I mean, yes, it is very dark, though I would argue. The fact that Aunt Fig treats the girl like absolute shit is far darker.
Oh, of course they're alive. They survived Thanksgiving dinners more threatening than that.
I mean, it's not that surprising that they are alive. In most kids' movies and kids' media in general, the protagonist always survives somehow. Now, there are of course movies where a major character dies, such as Mufasa's death in The Lion King, but most of the times it's just a villain that dies.
Tom and Jerry start doing what they should have been doing throughout this entire movie. I love this little circle here, like, yep, that's what it's all about.
Look, even if I did like the slapstick in the Tom and Jerry show, I don't. I think it's boring. I still wouldn't think it's a good idea to have slapstick for over 2 hours straight. I mean, that does work for a 7-minute short, but it wouldn't work for over an hour long movie. It would get old very quickly.
But nope, that's not what this film is about. I'll tell you exactly what this film is about. An hour and a half too long!
And how exactly is the length a problem? This is literally the first time you brought it up. Now I assume that you meant that Tom and Jerry wouldn't work for over an hour long movie. But there is another problem with what you said here. The movie is less than 90 minutes long. So it's not an hour and a half too long.
This film is awful. The lowest form of shit. It sucks ass. It sucks balls. It sucks ass balls.
You might as well say that it sucks gigantic gorilla dick while you're at it.
If I was to go back in time to tell the Tom and Jerry of 50 years ago that they would be making a film of this caliber about them, what do you think they'd have to say about it? I'm trying not to.
So wait a minute, you showed a clip from the original shorts of Tom talking? So why the hell were you bitching about Tom and Jerry talking earlier on in the review? The fact that they sometimes did in the original shorts really destroys your argument. Now it's time for my overall thoughts. I am not gonna fault the nostalgia critic for hating the movie because it butchers something that he loves. Hell, I feel the same way about the 2010 remake of A Nightmare on Elm Street as well as this verse too. But the problem that I have with this review is that some of his reasons for hating the movie are petty. Such as the fact that Tom and Jerry talked and the simple fact that there are songs. Those are pretty bad reasons to hate the movie. But at the same time though, this review is far from bad. But I can't say it's exactly good either. In fact, I would say that this review is just okay. As for what I think of the movie itself, well, honestly, I think the movie is fucking awesome. Much better than Tom and Jerry Show itself, which I still fucking hate. And that's basically the end of the video. Thank you for watching and have a great day.